Hello guys, welcome and good morning. Welcome to Unacademy Studios Bridge. Continuing with the series of gate previous year problems that we are solving right now from mechanics of solids. Let us go ahead and try doing it for shear and bending. Because shear and bending is a big part, therefore we are going to divide it into three subparts. And these three subparts are like in the current part we'll be covering the load, and then we'll cover in the second part we'll cover the stresses, in the third part we'll cover the deformations or deflections. So guys, we've already as you know, if you have been watching this entire series, then we have already covered axial loading and we have already covered torsional loading. And now is the time we cover other two type of loads that are shear and bending. So basically this entire session is going to be regarding SFD and BMD. Those who don't know me, I'm Marut Tiwari. I did my master's from IIT Kharagpur. I've been a recipient of multiple awards, cracked gate multiple times, and I'm also an author of the book Gate in 75 Days that you can check out at Amazon and Flipkart. And in general on Google. I'm currently associated with Unacademy platform. Unacademy is having a very good pool of educators, an outstanding pool of educators. And Unacademy is going to provide you number of courses even for free. And my dear friends, you can have flexible schedule. You can go for language of your choice. You can attend the session, you know, English sessions, or you can attend the Hindi sessions. Hindi sessions are going to be bilingual. In fact, all other local language sessions are going to be bilingual, where the content will be in English, but communication will be in your local language. So you can go for Hindi sessions and you can watch things as many times as you want. And while you subscribe for the Plus courses, my dear friends, you can, in real time, you can chat with the educators and you can ask them any doubts, and in real time, they can answer the things and they can float interactive polls. You can participate in those polls and you can keep learning from any time, from anywhere, and you can learn any time as long as you have a mobile device and you have a moderate speed internet. That's all what is required. So there are so many things, like we have subscription packages also available in flexibility. You can go for monthly package, 3 months package, 6 months package, 12 months package, and 24 months package. The 24 months package thing is available at 40,000 rupees one time payment, and the 12 months package is 12 months subscription is available at 25,000 rupees. But guys, if you take it effectively per month, if you calculate it effectively per month, then it comes down to just 1667 rupees per month. If you go for 2 years subscription, and if you go for 1 year subscription, then my dear friends, it comes down to just effectively, it's going to cost you just 2083 rupees per month. If you're going to use my code MTLIVE at the time of subscription, if you're going to use my code MTLIVE at the time of subscription, then you get 10% additional discount. After getting 10% additional discount, you have to pay 10% lesser value, which is 36,000. And if you go for 12 months subscription, then instead of paying 25,000, you'll have to pay just 22,500. So 22,500. Now, if you once again calculate it per month basis, then if you go for 2 years subscription, it will be effectively costing you just 1500 rupees per month. And if you go for 1 year subscription, it will be costing you 1875 rupees per month. So guys, you see that you have, if you monthly calculate it, it's as low as 1500 rupees per month, and this is unprecedented, this is unmatchable. If you compare it with any gate learning program out there, my dear friends, this is something that is unmatchable. given the fact that you get such an outstanding quality. Now, I can tell you so many reasons, I can tell you so many motivations to prepare GATE through Unacademy platform, but I'll give you just one thing, and just one reason is enough in my view, in my perspective. That one reason is that you have got the right to choose. You've got the right to choose. Now, what do I mean by this? I mean by this that when you go for any conventional classroom coaching program, then you don't have a choice to select your teacher. You don't have a choice to select your educator. But here on Unacademy Learning Platform, my dear friends, you have, as a student paying fees, you have the privilege, you have the right to select your educator. Because on Unacademy Learning Platform, one course, any given course, is available from so many educators. So Mr. A is also taking the same course, Mr. B is also taking the same course, Mr. C is also taking the same course, Mr. D is also taking the same course. It is up to you that you are liking Mr. A's course, you continue with that. Or if you are liking Mr. B's course, you continue with that. You are liking Mr. C's course, you continue with that. So like that, you guys get the chance to choose the things, chance to select the things. It's up to you. All right. This should not create confusion that you'll have to select a teacher at the time of subscription. No. You can subscribe for the packages, and then all the courses are available, and you can watch any one of them. You can watch any course from any educator out there. Just select GATE as your goal. And my dear friends, after that, go ahead and subscribe for the things. I assure you that you are not going to regret your decision. This is the best and the easiest and the most convenient way to learn GATE. All right. So this is the best way to prepare for GATE. Those of my friends who are preparing for GATE 2021, my dear friends, go ahead, do the subscriptions, and whenever you are subscribing for the things, make sure that you use my code MTLIVE to get 10% additional discount. Now let us come to the topic. The topic in hand is shear force and bending moment. Shear force and bending moment. Guys, if you have not already watched my axial loading and torsional loading sessions, then I would recommend you to first complete that axial loading and torsional loading session and then come to this shear force and bending moment session. Why? Because in continuity, you are going to certainly enjoy it. But just in case, if you are not interested in axial and torsional loading, you directly want to study SFNBM, shear force and bending moment diagrams, no problem. You can still continue here and you will understand each and everything. Before we go ahead and start solving problems, my dear friends, you need to know few things. And these few things are, let me tell you, that as far as shear force is concerned, shear force, my dear friends, will be calculated. This is the very first thing that you must remember. It will be calculated from either side. And if you have attended my axial loading and torsional loading session, then you know that this is nothing new to you. I've been repeatedly telling you either side. So either side is something that you have been learning now in so many sessions out there. Either side means what? That whenever you are calculating the shear force at any given section, you will have to look on either the left side or the right side. All right. So this is how you'll have to proceed. And then, my dear friends, you'll have to remember a convention. That convention is that convention is that if you are calculating from the left side, then upward will be treated as positive and downward will be treated as negative. But just in case if you are calculating from the right side, then downward will be treated as positive and upward will be treated as negative. So just keep this convention. This is the very first thing that you got to keep in your mind. That how would you calculate the shear force? You calculate the shear force from either side. And then if you are calculating it from the left side, then upward is going to be positive and downward is going to be negative. If you're calculating from the right side, then downward is going to be positive and upward is going to be negative. Now, similarly, for bending moment, my dear friends, you got to remember, for bending moment, please do remember, for bending moment, do remember this, that once again, you will calculate, the bending moment from either side. And my dear friends, for bending moment also, you'll have to remember a convention. That if you're calculating from the left side, then clockwise will be treated as positive and anti-clockwise will be treated as negative. But if you are calculating from the right side, then anti-clockwise will be treated as positive and clockwise will be treated as negative. So this is something you must keep in mind, that either side is something powerful, and it is a concept that we are following in this entire subject of mechanics of solids. And convention you must remember, for bending moment, whenever you are calculating from the left side, clockwise will be positive, anti-clock negative. If you are calculating from the right side, then anti-clock will be positive and clock will be negative. Apart from these two things, here is the third thing that you must remember. And the third thing is, that just in case, my dear friends, if there is any distributed load on the beam. Now, what is a distributed load? Distributed load is going to be acting on like entire length of the beam. Like, you know, at every single point of the beam, you'll have some load available, something like this. So if you have a distributed load, then we define load intensity for this distributed load. We define load intensity for this distributed load as what? As load per unit length. Just keep this in mind, that for distributed loads, continuously acting loads, load intensity is a parameter that is defined as load per unit length. And my dear friends, the shear force F, If we represent the shear force by F, and if we represent the bending moment by M, then shear force F, bending moment M, and this load intensity omega, they have a relation. And that relation is df by dx is equal to minus omega. So we have a relation between these three parameters, the load intensity and the shear force and the bending moment. First relation is df by dx is equal to minus omega. Second relation is dm by dx is equal to f. And third relation is d2m by dx2 is equal to minus omega. But these relations are valid. These differential equations are valid only when your distributed load is acting in the direction of gravity. Just keep this in mind, that these differential equations are valid only when your distributed load is acting downward. Just in case, if the distributed load is acting upward, then the differential equations will be changed a little bit. And what is the change that we are going to have? Guys, the second equation will remain unchanged, but the first one and the third one, they will have plus sign now. So just in case, if you have opposite to gravity load, if you have upward load, then we have the similar differential equations, but first one and the third one, they will have plus sign. I say it once again, please do remember these three things end of the day, and you'll be able to solve any problem based on SFD-BMD. Number one, shear force or bending moment, they will be calculated from either side. It's your wish whether you calculate from the left side or you calculate from the right side. And my dear friends, convention is that for shear force, if you're calculating from the left side, upward must be positive and downward must be negative. And if you're calculating from the right side, then downward must be positive and upward must be negative. For bending moment, if you're calculating from left, then clock positive, anti-clock negative. Similarly for right, opposite. And these relations must be embedded. They must be memorized completely and they must be, you know, absorbed completely so that you don't forget these. You don't ever forget these relations. Keeping these things in mind, let us go ahead and try solving this 2001 problem. This 2001 problem says that a cantilever beam is there and that cantilever beam is subjected to UDL, subjected to uniformly distributed load. Then bending moment diagram will be what? Is it going to be a straight line or is it going to be an ellipse or is it going to be a hyperbola or a parabola? Now, most of the people, I know most of you must be knowing this already. I know that most of you must be knowing it already, that if you have a UDL, if you have a uniformly distributed load, if you have a uniformly distributed load, then I hope all of you know that it is going to be parabolic. For UDL, bending moment is going to be parabolic. Bending moment will be varying with x square. Bending moment will be dependent on x square. Now, you can prove this by following one of the two fundas. One funda is either side. One funda that you can use is either side. What is the funda of either side? The funda of either side is that you have to look wherever you want to calculate the bending moment value, you have to look on either side of that section. Now, on either side of this section, how much is the load? Is it the total UDL or is it the partial UDL? Naturally, it is the partial UDL only. I mean, I know that most of you know it, but I'm just proving it. I'm just, you know, evolving it fundamentally, that how you can, if there is some different load given, how you can evolve that bending moment is going to vary parabolically or is it going to vary cubically or is it going to vary exponentially? It's very easy. It can be done in two ways. One way is either side. Using either side concept, you can very clearly see that this much UDL on either side of the section is nothing but omega x, and you can assume it to be applicable at x by 2. So now if you calculate from either side, bending moment value is gonna be, if you calculate from either side, my dear friends, bending moment value is going to be minus omega x available at x by 2. So you get omega x square by 2, because bending moment is depending upon x square. It's very clearly going to have a parabolic variation. Fourth option is correct. Congratulations, you get 1 mark. But same thing I can do using my differential equation, d2m by dx2 is equal to minus omega. d2m by dx2 is equal to minus omega. This one I can use to achieve the same result. So we have d2m by dx2 is equal to minus omega. Now if I integrate this, you know, the integration of second derivative is going to become the first derivative. On the right hand side, we are going to have omega dx plus an unknown constant. Let us integrate it once again, because we are interested in m. So if we integrate it once again, we get dm integration is going to become m. And then you'll have double integration of omega dx. Integration of a will become ax, and another unknown constant will come here, isn't it? Now for UDL, omega is a constant thing. For UDL, omega is a constant thing. So you can replace omega by a constant thing here. You can replace omega by a constant thing. That's why we call it UDL, uniformly distributed load, because in such a load intensity will remain constant. So now the integration of C will become what? Integration of C will become CX. Integration of C will become CX, and we have to integrate it once again. And if we integrate it once again, then we get CX square by 2. We get CX square by 2 plus AX plus B. So once again, we prove that bending moment is depending upon X square. Bending moment is depending upon X square. And if it is depending upon X square, then it is parabolic. So I've solved this particular thing. I've proved this particular thing in two possible ways. Please do remember both these concepts. I told you this relation also, and I told you the concept of either side also, and you get the same result. You prove the same result using any of the methods. So please do remember all these, you know, summary of the concepts that I told you. 2003 problem that they asked for 1 mark. This is a 2003 problem that they asked for 1 mark. The problem goes like this, that we have a simply supported beam, and on that simply supported beam at a distance L by 3, we have a load P acting. And my dear friends, we have to calculate the bending moment where the load is acting. We have to calculate the bending moment at the point where the load has been applied. So we have something like this. We have a simply supported arrangement, and that simply supported arrangement is having a load P available at L by 3 from the left support. Naturally, from the right support, the distance will become 2L by 3. Now, we have to calculate the bending moment value at this particular point here where the load is available. But that we can calculate only from either side. We can calculate either from left or right. And to calculate that bending moment value from left or right, we must know the reaction. At least we know the reaction. We should know the reaction at one extreme. If we are not interested in calculating both R1 and R2, at least we should calculate R1 value. To calculate the R1 value, we will try balancing the moments about C. We'll try balancing the moments about C. The moment of R1 is R1 into L clockwise, And the moment of P is P into 2L by 3 anticlockwise. So we have L getting cancelled here, L getting cancelled here, and we get the R1 value as what? We get the R1 value as 2P by 3. So we get the reaction here as 2P by 3. This simply supported beam is there. This simply supported beam is available. And in this simply supported beam, you have 2P by 3. Naturally, the other reaction will become P by 3. And you have P available here. And this distance is L by 3. Now, let us use the concept of either side. Let us use the concept of either side to calculate the bending moment here at point B. To calculate the bending moment here at point B, it's your wish, sir. It's your wish that whether you want to calculate from the left side or you want to calculate from the right side. You can calculate from any one given side. So if we calculate from the left side, we have only one force, that is 2P by 3, available at L by 3. And this is how you get 2PL divided by 9, calculating this value from the left side. And you see, you have option 4 as the correct one. So guys, as I have been repeatedly saying, that the concept of either side is always going to work whenever you need to calculate load in this particular subject, mechanics of solids. In this particular subject, mechanics of solids, whenever you are calculating the load, whether it is axial load or it is torsional load or it is shear load or it is bending load, please make sure that my dear friends, you remember the concept of either side. Now let us go ahead and try solving this 2005 problem that they asked for 1 mark. Now this particular problem is a typical problem where, once again, without knowing those differential equations that I told, you'll not be able to approach to this problem. Why? Because they are saying that qualitatively, which one is the correct bending moment diagram here? 4 options are given. I have not included those options here. So let me just write them quickly. Let me just complete them quickly. My dear friends, the examiner provided in this particular problem, the examiner provided 4 options of bending moment diagram. One option was something like this. Another option was something like this. Yet another option was something like this. So in this particular GATE 2005 problem that they asked for 1 mark, guys, they provided 4 different bending moment diagram values. I mean, 4 different bending moment diagrams. And they said that you need to select the correct one, that which one is representing the correct bending moment diagram. All right, just qualitatively, that means just by looking at the curvature and the shape, we don't have to bother about the values. There is nothing that we have to do about the values. We don't have to calculate any value. So guys, one distinct feature here is that on half of the beam, you have the load acting in the direction of gravity. On another half of the beam, you have the load acting opposite to the direction of the gravity. And you remember something I told you, for gravity and for opposite to gravity, for downward and for upward, these are the equations. I told you for downward acting distributed loads, I told you the relation of bending moment with load intensity as minus omega. But my dear friends, for opposite to gravity loads, I told you that the relation of bending moment with load intensity is plus omega. So I told you that we have similar relations, only minus and plus sign. They are different things. So now we know that for gravity load, the second derivative of bending moment is negative. For gravity load, for downward load, the second derivative is negative. And the second derivative is negative. If your little bit of basics of calculus is okay, if your little bit, you know, fundamentals of calculus is all right, then only you will understand this. That if second derivative is negative, then that means first derivative is decreasing. And if the first derivative is decreasing, shall the curve be like this red one, or shall the curve be like this blue one? You think about this. For a downward acting load, d2m by dx2 is equal to minus omega. Second derivative is negative. Second derivative is negative means what? Second derivative is negative means that first derivative is decreasing with x. And the second derivative, if the first derivative is decreasing, then that means the slope must decrease. And the slope must decrease, if the slope must decrease, you figure out that whether this red one should be the correct curvature or this blue one should be the correct curvature. My dear friends, if the slope has to slow down, if the slope has to decrease continuously, then you can see here in this red one, you have the slope positive and then less positive and then zero and then negative. So slope has to decrease and it is decreasing here only. You think about it, positive slope and then less positive slope and then zero slope and then negative slope. So slope is continuously decreasing. And if the slope is decreasing, my dear friends, this one is the correct one. Here the slope is increasing, you see, zero slope is there and then the slope becomes positive. So here the slope is increasing. This can't be correct. So wherever you have gravity, load acting in gravity, there the bending moment diagram must be concave down. There the bending moment diagram must be concave down. This is what we have. This is what we have. It must be concave down. Similarly, for opposite to gravity load, my dear friends, second derivative is positive. And if the second derivative is positive, then that means first derivative must increase with x. And if it must increase with x, then the slope must increase. If the slope must increase, then this time which one is the correct one? Is this curvature representing the correct one? Or this curvature representing the correct one? Naturally, if the slope has to increase, you see here, negative slope, zero slope and positive slope. Negative slope, zero slope and positive slope. So negative slope is there, zero slope is there and positive slope is there. Slope is increasing here and therefore this one is correct and this one is not. That means for opposite to gravity load, it must be concave looking from the top side. It must be concave looking from the top side, just like it is here, just like it is here, and just like it is here. It must be concave looking from the top side. So guys, this is what we have. This is what we have, where both our conclusions are matching. In the third option, they both are matching, and therefore the third option is the correct option. The third option is the final answer. Now let us go ahead and try solving this 2007 problem. This 2007 problem is giving us a simply supported beam. How do I know that it is a simply supported beam? Because you have a reaction here and you have a reaction here. Then we have a frame, and that frame is having this 100 Newton force. First of all, let us transfer this 100 Newton force to the midpoint of the beam. This is 100 mm, let's change it to meter. This is 500 mm, let's change it to meter again. And this is again 500 mm, let us change it to meter. So if I transfer this 100 Newton force to the midpoint of the beam, then I'll get two things. I'll get 100 and I'll get 100 into 0.1, which is 10 Newton meter couple. After transferring this, my dear friends, we have at the midpoint of the beam, we have 100 Newton force and we have 10 Newton meter moment. Let us try finding out at least one reaction to find out R1 value, to find out R1 value. We'll try balancing the moments about C. This entire length is nothing but 1 meter and this much length is nothing but 0.5 meter. So let us try balancing the moments about C. If we try balancing the moments about C, then we have about C, what is the moment of R1? The moment of R1 about C is R1 into 1 clockwise. Then there is this 10 Newton meter of clockwise moment. But please do remember that whenever you have a concentrated moment, don't multiply it with any distance. Don't multiply with any distance. This is again a clockwise moment. On the other hand, you have 100 into 0.5. 100 into 0.5. So from here you get R1 plus 10 is equal to 50. And this is how you get R1 value as 40. You get the R1 value as 40. So R1 value is now known to us. R1 value is now known to us. R1 value is 40. Let us go ahead and try calculating the bending moment values. Bending moment value will be calculated from either side. Either side is the concept, you know. So at A, if you follow the either side concept, how much moment is present on the left side? If you follow at A, my dear friends, if you follow the either side concept, there is nothing on left side of A. So on the left side of A, there is nothing. Therefore, you get the zero value. At B, the value is nothing but 40 into 0.5. At B, if you calculate the value, it is 40 into 0.5. So at B, the value is 40 into 0.5. This is nothing but 20 Newton meter. This is nothing but 20 Newton meter. Now there is a catch. And the catch is that at B, you'll have to calculate one more value. At B, you'll have to calculate one more value. And that one more value you'll calculate by summing up everything from either side, but you'll calculate this value just after B. Why? Because my dear friends, there is a couple acting here, so bending moment will have a sudden change. Therefore, at B you'll have to calculate one more value. And that one more value you'll calculate by taking a point just after B. We'll write it as B plus. We'll write it as B plus. All right. So at B plus doesn't mean that you have to go far away from B. No, you are essentially calculating at B only, but just after B, just immediately after B. So immediately after B, it will become 14 to 0.5 plus this 10, and this value is nothing but 30. This value is nothing but 30. Finally, at C, the bending moment value is gonna be 0. Why 0? Because there is nothing on the right side of C. So guys, this is how you calculate the bending moment values. Though we have got our answer, but just to get a better feeling, let us try drawing this diagram that you have one reaction here and you have another reaction here. In between you have 100 Newton and you have 10. For this we have already constructed the bending moment diagram, and that bending moment diagram is that you have at A you have 0 value, and then my dear friends, at B you have the value 20. But at B there is one more value that we calculated. So at B there will be a sudden change. This sudden change is happening because of the couple. So wherever couple is available, there will be a sudden change in the bending moment value, and then that bending moment value becomes 30, and then finally it will come down to 0 once again. This is how you complete the bending moment diagram. Guys, for this particular beam, now you can read the maximum bending moment. Maximum bending moment is nothing but 30 Newton meter here. So this is how we complete this particular problem. As a fifth problem, this is a very easy problem. 2011 problem that they asked for 1 mark. You have to calculate reactions. Guys, if you want, for this, this is a standard beam. And for this standard beam, whenever you have hinge or maybe one side hinge and one side roller, and if you have a couple acting anywhere in that simply supported beam, just remember that reactions are always going to be, for such a case, reactions are always going to be equal and opposite. And their values are going to be m0 by l. Their values will be m0 by l. If you remember this standard result, then it is 1 divided by 1. So the reactions are going to be 1 and 1. And because your active couple is clockwise, so your reactive couple must be anti-clockwise. And to produce a reactive couple anti-clockwise, RQ must be upward and RP must be downward. So RQ must be upward and RP must be downward. So this is how you get it. But just in case, if you don't remember all this, then you can calculate the reactions very easily just by balancing the moments, just like we did it here, just like we did it in the previous problem. So this is how you can calculate it. Let us now try solving this 2017 problem that they asked. Okay, let me complete this, because there is one little concept that you might not be knowing. I want you to know that. I just want you to know that. What is that concept? Guys, you see, you have, let's say you have a couple, and that couple is acting anywhere. It doesn't matter really. And let's say this reaction is RP and this reaction is RQ. I'm just completing it for the sake of telling you something that might appear in some problems. Now if I balance all the moments about P, Then about P, we have M naught, which is clockwise, and we have RQ into L, which is anti-clockwise. We have RQ into L, which is anti-clockwise. So RQ value will be what? RQ value will be 1 line you get the RQ value is going to be M naught divided by L. And because you are getting positive sign, so that means whatever you assumed as the direction of RQ, that is absolutely correct. But now if I use sigma Fy is equal to 0, then I have RP upward plus RQ upward, but there is no downward load, there is no other force than RP and RQ. Now RQ value is what? RQ value is M naught by L. So you'll get RP as what? You'll get RP as minus M naught divided by L. You'll get RP value as minus M naught divided by L. Now minus sign means what? To remember this, that whenever you are calculating reactions and you get minus sign in an answer, then that means that the direction is opposite. That means the direction that you assumed is not correct. This doesn't mean that your value is not correct. Your value is still absolutely correct, but the direction that you assumed is incorrect. So you just need to change that direction. That's it. Now let us try solving this 2017 problem. This 2017 one mark problem. In this particular problem, guys, we have the bending moment equation is given, and giving the bending moment equation where x is in millimeter, giving the bending moment equation, they are asking the shear force value. Now, if they are giving you the bending moment value and they are asking the shear force value, then you know you will have to use the relation between bending moment and shear force that I told. What was the relation that is there between shear force and bending moment? The relation between shear force and bending moment is this one, dm by dx is equal to f. This one, dm by dx is equal to f. I told you that, and look, I have not solved even one problem using any concept that I already not described. So I've already described whatever concepts I told you. Notice that every single problem we are solving using these concepts only. We are solving all these problems. So, okay, this one, bending moment is given to you and they are asking the shear force value. Let's go ahead and try solving this. We have the relation dm by dx is equal to f. So we have f is equal to dm by dx, and m value is known to you, so we can differentiate this. M value is given to you, 5x square plus 10x. So the differentiation of this 5x square plus 10x will be what? The differentiation of this will be 5 into 2x, and for this 10x, we'll have 10 only because differentiation of x is 1. So we get from here the shear force value as 10x plus 10. They are asking at x is equal to 10 mm. So you can calculate at x is equal to 10 mm. And you get the final answer as 110 is the final answer. So guys, this is how, using those 3-4 things that I told you, you can solve any problem, you can approach to any problem, You just need to have a little practice and then you'll be done. So I just hope that you are following all these sessions. In the next session, I'll be solving these 2 marks problem, this 2004 problem, and then this 2005 problem, where I'll tell you about the internal hinge and how should you approach to the internal hinge problems very quickly. And then guys, we'll be solving this 2006 problem and 2010 problem and 2013 problem, 15-1, where once again you have internal hinge, where once again you have internal hinge. So if you want to know that how to solve internal hinge problems very quickly and within a matter of seconds, please follow my next session. And then 2015 problem, and then it will be the end of the next session. Before you wind up this particular session, hit the bell icon. Why? Because you keep receiving my notifications of my videos, and subscribe for the plus packages using my code MTLIVE to get 10% additional discount. Thank you very much for watching the session. I just hope that you are enjoying this series of previous year problems. And through these previous year problems, my real intention is to complete your revision of strength of material subject, to complete your solids subject, mechanics of solids subject, just before your GATE exam. So wish you all the best once again. Thank you very much.